If you've just updated to Windows 10, I'm about to show you 10 tips, tricks, and features that'll help you get the most out of this operating system. Hi guys, welcome back to Tony Dawson Tech. If you're new here, welcome. And if you're not, welcome back. Let's get straight into it. Now, the new Windows 10 update has been out for a couple of weeks now. Codename 20H1. This was Windows Update 2004. Now, whether you're a power user or an occasional user, there'll be something here for you. I'm not gonna waste any more time. Let's get down to top 10 tips and tricks for Windows 10. Now, the first one is an old favorite. It was actually brought out in Windows 7, but it's still just effective in Windows 10 today. Now, we've all been there when you've got multiple windows open on the screen and you just wanna get rid of some. You could individually go to each window and minimize them so you've only got the one that you're working on left. But there's a quicker way. If you left click on the active window that you've got open and give it a shake, all windows will minimize apart from that one. Simple. And if you want them all back, all you have to do is click on it again and shake and it will bring them all back. Number two seems a simple one. It's how to take a screenshot. Now there's 8 different ways in Windows 10 to take a screenshot. Now the easiest way to do this is simply to press Windows and print screen key, and that will save that screenshot in the pictures folder in a folder called screenshots. The best way to do a screenshot now is by using Snip and Sketch. And you can get to that by pressing the Windows key, Shift, and the letter S. This is quite a versatile tool. You can either have rectangular, window, freeform, or full screen. It'll let you annotate it, it'll let you highlight stuff. Okay, so this is Snip and Sketch. All you need to do is press Windows, Shift, and S. And the Snip and Sketch menu will come up. You've got a rectangular snip, freeform snip, a window snip, or just a full screen snip. What we want is a rectangular for this instance. Click on it, click and drag. You've got it saved, and it comes up and it's saved to the clipboard to paste where you want. There you go, have a play around with it. Miles better than the snipping tool. Number three is a cool trick, which I confess I only learned about probably about a year ago, and it's a slide down to shut off. Here's how to set it up. So this is pretty simple to set up. Once you're on your desktop, right click, go down to new, select shortcut. Type in what's on the screen now. There will be a link in the description. Click on next and finish. What happens is you get this shortcut on the desktop that's called Slide to Shut Down. To save those extra precious seconds, all you need to do is double click on that. This appears. Now, if you slide this window all the way down, the computer will start shutting down. We don't need to do that for now, so let's get back to it. Number four is Dictation. It's a tool I'd never thought I'd ever use. It's been in Windows quite a while, but it's been pretty poor. But now it's actually quite a useful tool. If you're going to use it, I use it for my YouTube scripts. Instead of typing things out or writing it down, open up Word and start dictating. Okay, Dictation is easy to set up. Once you've got your text program open, whether Notepad or Word or whatever you want to be, once you're in there, all you need to do is press the Windows key and H and it will start listening and it will start typing what you're saying. Very clever. Saves loads of time. Now, number five is one that admittedly I don't use that often, if ever, but I can see it being very popular in today's society, and that's an emoji and symbols menu. Anyway, you type in, just hit the Windows and full stop key and you will bring up the menu to choose your emoji or symbol, just like this. Okay, to get up your emoji and symbols menu, wherever you're typing, whether that be chatting or again in some sort of text document, you're typing along. Like I said, all you need to do is hit the Windows and the full stop key and you get the emoji menu or the symbols menu all along the bottom, and choose which ones you want. Go ahead, try it. Now, number six is for those power users. Settings are all over the place in Windows, different menus, different ways to get to them. Now there's an old Easter egg that's still available in Windows 10 and it's called GodMode. It puts all the most useful and widely used settings into one folder as such, and it's a doddle to set up. Let me show you. Okay, GodMode is easy to set up as well. It's pretty similar to SlideToShutDown. Once you're on your desktop, right click, go down to New. This time you're going to select Folder, and you need to rename the folder with the text that's on the screen now, or just copy it from the description. Once that's renamed, press Enter. And when you've entered it, it will turn into this icon here. Double click, and you'll see all the settings that you could ever want, all in one place. Easy. As always, I've cheated a little bit here. I've put two together in one category, and that's a time difference and calculator options. Now the calculator has been around for years in Windows. In its early days, it was just simply a calculator, but now it's got so many features. If you open up the options menu, you see what you can do with the calculator, from a scientific calculator, to working out area, to a currency converter. All those tools just in the calculator app. Now the next one is great if you've got friends and family that lives in different parts of the world. It allows you just to simply have a look and calculate the time difference between them all. If you go to the search bar and type alarms and clock, and then click on the clock, you'll see the map of the world, and you can pinpoint where everybody lives, and you can see the time difference between where you are. Handy little feature. Number 8 is the cloud clipboard. This allows you to save multiple items to the clipboard and select which ones you want to paste, but of course it's saved in the cloud, so you could save from one device and paste it into another device using the cloud clipboard. I'll show you how to turn it on now. Okay, to set up your cloud clipboard, go to settings. In the settings, you need to go to system, and on the left hand side, go to clipboard. Once you're in there, turn your clipboard history on and turn on sync across devices. From there, once you have copied something, if you press Windows V, it will bring up the clipboard that you can sync across devices and paste it as and when you need it. Number 9 is Dynamic Lock. Pretty nifty. It pairs Windows 10 with your phone, so if you pick your phone up and walk away from the screen, it will automatically lock your session. Ideal if you're in a public place, or maybe you have quite a few roommates. It takes away that forgetfulness of you locking your screen, and it will lock it automatically. Here's how to set it up. Okay, to turn on Dynamic Lock, again you need to go into Settings, go to Accounts. In the accounts, go to Sign In Options. Once you're in Sign In Options, if you scroll down, you will find Dynamic Lock. Tick to turn it on. Allow Windows to lock your device automatically when you're away. Just remember to pick up your phone when you move, because it goes off your phone. Obviously, from there, you'll need to link your phone as well. Number 10 is something called Storage Sense. This essentially removes temporary files that aren't being used by any of your installed programs to free up space automatically. It'll automatically empty the recycle bin after 30 days. It'll let you configure a manual cleanup, which is always handy after a Windows update. Here's how to activate it. Okay, to turn storage settings on, again, we need to go into the settings menu, into system, and then down the left-hand side, you'll find storage. In storage, it's the first one you come to. There's a little slide there where you can turn Storage Sense on. That's how you turn it on. If you click on configure, you can configure what it can and can't do, so you can personalize it. Have a look at it, see what you can do. There you go. As always, I've got a bonus for you, and this one's called Power Toys. This is an open source project by Microsoft, but weirdly, it's not available on the Microsoft Store. I'll leave the link down below, but you have to download it from GitHub. This is one of those features that could take a whole video on its own. It's probably actually there for power users again, but there are some nifty little toys in there. Now, power toys came about in Windows 95, all those years ago, and it's still available now for Windows 10. There's too many things to mention. I'll show you how to set it up now. Have a play around. Let me know what you think. Okay, to install Power Toys, go to the link in the description. It'll take you to this, or whatever is the latest release, depending on when you're watching this. Go down to the bottom and you'll see Power Toys setup. Double click that, it'll download the installer. Once it's downloaded, double click that, run the installer. So it installs, and you will get, if you choose, you will get a shortcut, or you can open it from the start menu. And there's loads of toys in here. Too many to go into, so if you want to see that, just let me know. I'll do a full video on Power Toys, but there's loads of stuff in there. And that's how you set up Power Toys. There you go. I hope you found something beneficial in there. If you want me to go into anything more detail, especially the Power Toys, please let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed it, please give me a thumbs up. It really does help. There'll be more of these to come. If you haven't subscribed yet, that button's up here. Love it if you subscribe to join the gang. If not, here's another video that might convince you otherwise. For now, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.